rate intervals, axis and B ways. Hypertrophy that's massive and how the R's relay. QT morphology that view the ST segments. Compared to old EKGs, do you see any difference? Rhythm rate intervals, axis and B ways. Hypertrophy that's massive and how the R's relay. QT morphology that view the ST segments. Compared to old EKGs, do you see any difference? What's the rhythm? Regular or irregular? Find the R to R, P to P, and measure them. What's the rate going at, knowing that we all care? 300 over R to R and large square. The other's more specific, but harder, cuz it's 1500 over the smaller ones. Next are the intervals critical. Check PR, QRS, and QT in a row. Then you need to guess what's the axis. Up in 1 in ABF is the average. If they're ever negative or biphasic, it's imperative to do investigating. Might be a PE that's causing Q's in inverted T's in lead 3 and you caught it. Rhythm rate intervals, axis and P ways. Hypertrophy that's massive and how the R's relay. QT morphology then view the ST segments. Compared to old EKGs, do you see any difference? Rhythm rate intervals, axis and P ways. Hypertrophy that's massive and how the R's relay. QT morphology then view the ST segments. Compared to old EKGs, do you see any difference? Check the P wave and how it behaves. Inverted, absent, buried, or delayed. And tall R's and V1's certainly are caused by right side hypertrophy. And is the R wave transition seen before or after precordial leads V3, V4? Are the Q waves 25% of the R in contiguous leads of 1 millimeter across? Next, check for changes in the ST segments for elevations and depressions readily present. Last are the T wave changes. Are they peak, deep, or remain biphasic? Should you be scared? Hold up, you won't know till you compare it to the old one. Rhythm rate intervals, axis and P waves. Hypertrophy that's massive and how the R's relay. QT morphology then view the ST segments. Compared to old EKGs, do you see any difference? Rhythm rate intervals, axis and P waves. Hypertrophy that's massive and how the R's relay. QT morphology then view the ST segments. Compared to old EKGs, do you see any difference?